Welcome to QGIS 101. My name is Andreas de Jong. This is the second video in a three-part series. In the first video, I showed you how to process a digital elevation model. In this video, we're going to use that digital elevation model to derive a catchment. I hope you enjoy it. In this video, we're going to delineate the catchment of the Salma Dam in Afghanistan. We're going to be using QGIS 3.16 Hanover. Please make sure that you have the GRASS extension activated. The next step is to calculate the flow direction and the flow accumulation grid. The flow direction grid shows us the direction of the steepest downstream gradient. And the flow accumulation grid shows us how many cells contribute to the flow in every downstream cell. If we go to processing toolbox, we type in r.watershed, and here is the tool that we're looking for. Double click on it, and we need to have our filled DEM as the elevation grid, and we'll leave all of these other parameters the same, except this is very important. The minimum size of the exterior watershed basin, it has to be set to the pixel size, which is 30 meters. And the rest can be left, except this one. Let's enable the single flow direction. And there are many outputs here, but we don't need any of these bottom ones. Basically, we're just going to keep the first two. So this is the flow accumulation grid, the number of cells that drain through each cell. And let's save it, calling it DEM accumulation. And the next one is the flow direction grid. So I've called it DEM direction. Save and press run. Okay, it has finished execution. It took us 712 seconds, so that's quite a long time. Let's have a look at the results. So we need to turn off our filled and let's put the accumulation grid on top of the direction grid. Okay, so our flow direction grid is in a kind of a grayscale. That's okay, but I think we need to have a closer look at our flow accumulation grid. So in symbology, let's use pseudo color. We'll just classify this, say apply. Let's say apply. Okay. So our flow accumulation grid is showing us some of these tributaries. And our flow direction grid underneath it is showing us the direction of the flow. I can't see it properly because it is not transparent. So what we're going to do is here, the blending mode. I'm going to go to multiply for the blending mode, and then we should be able to see through it. Okay, not bad. So basically we have flow accumulation grid for the entire area, including the catchment outside of the Salma Dam. The next step is to delineate the catchment, and our output will be a catchment grid of the Salma Dam. Now, before we begin, let's switch on the satellite image and switch off the flow direction grid. You can see how our flow accumulation grid picks up all these little valleys quite nicely, and the Hari Rud River is represented by this dark blue line here. Okay, let's go to the processing toolbox and type outlet, and here's the tool we want, rwater.outlet.
double click to run. Now our input raster has to be the flow direction grid. And the second line here is very important, the coordinates of our outlet point. Click on the three little dots here on the right, and what we're going to do is select one of these dark points here from the flow accumulation grid, and I'm going to pick this one here, which is as close as we can to the dam axis, but slightly upstream of it. So now this is recorded the coordinates of our outlet point, and we don't have to change anything else, except here we will save the file as DM and press save and press run. Okay, the task is completed. Close. And what you see here is the entire catchment of Sama Dam shown as a raster. The next step is to convert our catchment raster to a vector, and our output will be a polygon of the Sama catchment. Make sure that our catchment raster has been selected. Go to Processing Toolbox, type r.to, and here it is, r2vect. Double click. Now our input raster layer is our catchment raster, which we selected earlier. Feature type is area, and this is important. Let's click smooth corners of area features, otherwise our polygon will have the same jagged edges as the raster. Under advanced parameters, output type, we should select area and then vectorize. This is the name of our file. Save to file, and I'm going to call it Sama catchment underscore 30 meter, and it's a shapefile. Let's run. Okay, it is completed, and I'm going to just make it hollow. So under simple fill, we select outline simple line, and maybe we'll make it red color, and stroke width a little bit bigger, apply, okay. All right, so this is basically our watershed, and I'm going to switch on the flow accumulation grid and our flow direction grid, so you can see that it has defined the outside of the Sama catchment quite accurately. There shouldn't be any streams crossing the outside of our catchment area. And I think that the grass tools have done a great job to come up with this result. Okay, so that's it. The catchment area has been defined as a polygon and also as a raster. I hope that you found this video interesting and useful, and that you'll watch the next video where I'll show you how to extract the streams from the Sama Dam catchment.